everybody. I'm Doc, and welcome to another episode of The Boneyard. Hey, listen, back when I started this journey back in April of this year, I think it was, I have a mantra that this is a safe zone, but not a comfort zone. Well, I just feel the need to reiterate that this is a safe zone, but not a comfort zone. It is my job in these podcasts to challenge you, my listener, to outstretch the limits of your boundaries, just as I do making these podcasts. These podcasts are not easy for me, folks. They hurt. It's hard. It's very hard. It makes me go to places that I would rather not go, but I'm willing to go there as an example to let you know that it is possible to overcome. And that's kind of what I wanted to lead into this week. Wanted to talk about a subject we all deal with to some extent. It's called fear. F-E-A-R. Fear. What is fear? What are you afraid of? What am I afraid of? Well, let's start with the textbook definition of the word fear. It says an unpleasant emotion caused by the belief that someone or something is dangerous, likely to cause pain or a threat. Now, that could be a real physical threat, or it could be a perceived threat. So, real or perceived? Well, that's up to us. So, I'm going to start this out by just laying some shit out there for you folks. What am I afraid of? Well, you want the God's honest truth, folks? Damn near everything. Now, I'm not to the point where I'm crippled in fear and not able to function. Hell no. No. I embrace fear. I am challenged by fear. I am motivated by fear. I spend my waking hours trying to conquer and overcome my fears. Yes. Yes, yes, I am a work in progress, folks. And when I say that I use all my waking energy to overcome and defeat these fears, yes, that is true. Ask anyone that knows me. I am a very strong and very confident individual, but I also have a very big weak side that not too many people get to see because I don't let them. Because I have that fear of being weak. But it's funny, you know, the greatest strength is found in the greatest weakness. Huh, that seems kind of messed up, doesn't it? How can there be fear and strength in weakness? Well, let's explore that. You know, my first podcast was about post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTS, whichever, you know, catchphrase you want to go by. In talking about that, I had to admit fear. I had to admit myself, or I had to admit to myself first, then to others, that I was afraid, that I am afraid. The strength it takes to say, I'm afraid, is unmeasurable. Now, that sounds like a strange dichotomy, doesn't it? Weakness and strength. Strength and weakness? Yeah, well, you know, it's what you find in the battle that makes a difference. So what do I do about fear? Well, I'm a dumbass, folks. I'm first to admit, I am a dumbass. D-U-M-B-A-S-S. Or jackass. Whichever S is more relevant to you, I'll let you pick. But yes, I do the same things over and over until I get it right. I'm a blockhead. A true Charlie Brown blockhead. But I eventually get it right. I'm stubborn. Oh, God, am I stubborn. I would run into a brick wall if I thought I could move it. Having said that, folks, there is a fear of failure associated with that. Oh, my God, he's psychoanalyzing himself. Yes, folks, fear of failure. Now, what exactly is failure? It depends on your perspective, folks. Failure can be opportunity to excel. Okay, yeah, I'll buy that. Fear is not lost. Fear is a opportunity to excel. Okay. Now, is that just psychobabble for, well, he's trying to rationalize and justify and all that psychobabble shit? No. No, folks. I do believe that if you don't do, you won't fail. If you won't fail, you won't learn. And if you don't learn, you won't exceed. So, yes. Who was it that said failure is not an option? Houston, we have a problem? Well, yeah. Okay, that's one of the things I'm afraid of. I used to be afraid of me, afraid of not being good enough in others' eyes, afraid of not being good enough in my own eyes, afraid of being who I am, of wanting to be somebody else because I thought somebody else was better than who I am. Well, you know, it took me a lot of years to finally pull my head out of my 4 points of contact there and, you know, figure out, hey, you know, you're not such a bad guy. You know your limitations. You know what works. You know what doesn't. You've learned the hard way. So, you know, I could say that I'm happy with how it turned out. Now, is there always room for improvement? Sure. But as far as that fear of who I was or who I wanted to be, now that pretty much came as a result of a conscious decision I made. I just simply chose not to be afraid anymore. Put that fear monster in a box, locked that bitch up tight, and threw that fucker in a closet somewhere. Pardon my French. So, what are you afraid of, my loyal and humble listeners out there? Are you afraid of being judged? That what you do isn't good enough to please others? Well, is that fear stopping you from achieving your full potential? Is the pain and hurt from your past keeping you from being who you want to be and can be? Is that fear of reverting back to that person keeping you from doing that? Hey, look, I was a living embodiment of that. Yes, folks, that was me. Me. Hands up, wagging in the wind, yeah, man. Point of finger down here, that's me. Or was me, correction. But, you know, like I said, I made a conscious decision. Now, is fear necessarily a bad thing? No. And I'm going to tell you why. If you're agoraphobic, like me, afraid of heights, unless I have to, I will not go in a tall building. I have a severe fear of structural heights. Now, to challenge myself and combat that, yes, I went ziplining. Because once you're dangling on that dead-eye steel cable, you know, 200-300 feet above the ground, scooting it, you know, 30-40 miles an hour, you kind of get over that fear real quick. And it's a challenge thing, you know. I'd like to challenge myself. The fear of the unknown is another one. I've come to the conclusion that why worry about shit I have no control over? Why fear that? Why let that steal my happiness, my peace of mind? Can't do anything about it anyway, right? So, why even go there? But fear can be crippling. Fear not only robs us of who we are, of who we want to be, of who we can be, but we do have the power to overcome that fear. That's the coolest part. We have the power. It all starts with making a decision. I am no longer afraid of. Now, you fill in the blank in. Yeah, it can be whatever. Fear that I'm not good enough. Fear that I don't deserve. Fear that I'm not smart enough. Fear that I'm not worthy of love and affection. And yeah, folks, I've had that. That fear of abandonment. And just a quick little anecdote here, so to speak. I was put up for adoption when I was, I think 10 or 11 years old. It was back in September 79. And I struggled for years with the fear of abandonment, that I wasn't good enough, that I did something wrong, that it was my fault. What could I have done? Could I have been a better kid? Well, with age comes wisdom. Hopefully. You know, hopefully you live and you learn. Well, it took me a long time, and there's still little bits and pieces of that fear of abandonment that do come out. Not gonna lie, it's an ongoing battle. I haven't fully crushed that bitch in a headlock yet. I'm still choking off its air supply. It's still squirming around. It comes out kicking and screaming every once in a while. But I just ratchet down the old forearm there and across that carotid, and hopefully sooner or later that bitch's head's gonna come off. Not really. It's a metaphor, people. I'm not really gonna commit murder, but to crush that fear. What else am I afraid of? Oh, let's see. We talked about afraid of the fear of failure, fear of abandonment. I've come to a place in my life, I'm 52 years old, where I don't have all the answers, but I have my answers. I no longer fear me. And for a long time, after I came back from Iraq, I was like that quiet monster that roamed the countryside there, folks. You know, I truly had no idea of who I was or what I was capable of. And I have struggled with that fear, the fear of finding out exactly who the hell I am and what I'm capable of. And I don't mean that in a good, positive, and wholesome way. I mean that as a dark, demon-esque kind of being, so to speak. But then again, you know, self-realization for me was a way to conquer that fear. To get to know who I am, who I was, and who I want to be. And come to that understanding and come to that acceptance. That's another thing that that dictates fear, is fear of acceptance. I'm not going to go all psychobabble-ish on you folks. But if you can't accept you for you, nobody else is going to accept you for you. It all starts on the inside, folks. You have to come to the point where you're able to look in the mirror and say, you know what? Yeah, I got some grays here and maybe a bald spot there. Wrinkles, yeah, okay. Ear hair growing where it didn't used to grow. Spare tire, ooh, Michelin tire man, baby. But you know what? I'm okay with that. It's all right. I accept it. So, fear can be a motivating factor, or fear can be crippling. But it's your choice. You get to choose what outcome fear has on you. And, you know, I've been in combat, folks. I've been afraid. I mean, like, seriously, serious shit afraid. And I channeled that. I conquered that fear. And I was no longer afraid in combat. Until I came closer to coming home, and then, you know, the fear of the unknown and all that. But yes, there is not an individual who walks this earth that is not afraid of something. I don't care if that individual has testicles that drag on the ground behind him and they have to get scooped up in a dump truck because they're that big. No. Everyone is afraid of something. It's what you do with that fear that makes a difference. That's what courage is all about, folks. Courage is not being a hero. Courage is being tired of being afraid and doing something about it. That's it. It's as simple as that. You know, I'm going to equate that to valor on the battlefield. The individuals that receive medals for valor on the battlefield are just regular people, folks. Regular people that are put in extraordinary circumstances that take extraordinary action, and they're afraid. But they grab that fear. They harness that fear. They channel that fear. And they perform despite of that fear. That's it. That's what it all comes down to, folks. You know, everybody has their own fears, which is normal. It's how we're wired. It's our quest for answers and our quest to ask questions to calm that fear. Fear is not necessarily a bad thing. It can be. It just depends on what you do with it, how you embrace it, how you let that fear work for you. So I'm going to take a quick musical interlude here, and I'm going to be back to you in a few minutes.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls inside my brain. I was screaming loud tonight. Can you hear? make waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. This is my fight song. Take back my life.
Wow, folks, that was a song called Fight Song, and that was by Rachel Platten. I figured it would be the perfect way to close out this podcast. Listen to the words, folks. Make it your fight song. Fight against fear. Don't let fear win. Conquer that bitch. Throw it in a chokehold. Choke off that carotid. Let it turn blue in the face. Rest in peace. As always, folks, I welcome your comments, suggestions, criticisms even. Hate mail. Hell, I'll even take hate mail. I'm not picky. At the boneyard2021@yahoo.com. That's the boneyard2021@yahoo.com. The Boneyard is a Whiskey 901 production. And as always, I thank you for joining me, letting me ramble on incessantly, allowing me to invade your mind and your headspace for just a few minutes each week. Much love. See you next time, folks.